Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Shubhada Group of Education SESI. You are watching Satish Sir's physics videos for Karnataka CET and NEET. So here I have taken a problem from scalars and vectors of class 11 or PUC 1 Karnataka syllabus. Look at the problem here. Two forces F1 vector equal to 500 Newton due east and F2 vector equal to 250 Newton due north. Find F2 vector minus F1 vector is a problem, right? So you can expect this such a problem on your Karnataka CET 2021 or else in many competitive examinations. And moreover, the scalars and vectors are a very fundamental concepts for physics, correct? Because they are the base parts for you people to learn the many of the vector notations in future. Okay, so let's try to find out the answer for this problem now. So once the question is given in terms of the direction, you should remember this one. Okay, so this is what the direction sense test we are using by convention. This should be the north direction, this is the south direction, and this is the east one, and this is the west one. Okay, so here, as they have given that the F1 vector is due east, the sense, let me use a different color to solve this problem now here. So this is what the direction of the F1 vector, and 250 Newton along the north. Okay, so this is the direction of what? F2, right? F2 vector, clearly. So now the question is to find out the value of F2 minus F1. Okay, so to subtract the two vectors, what you need to do here? It is same as what? Vector F2 plus minus of vector F1. Okay, in the sense, suppose if it is a plus F1, at that time the minus F1 will becomes what? Exactly reverse of that, correct or not? So that's the reason why it should be the minus F1 vector. So now the resultant diagram would be like this. How much? F1 is given as 500. Value will give you as something like 250, right? 250. Root 5. So angle also, correct? So F1 is given as 5 tan inverse of 2. So that's the reason why from west to east, west of north. So this is what the actual resultant. So that's the reason why option B should be the right answer for this question. So the resultant diagram would be like this. This is the F1, F2 vector, and this should be the minus F1 vector. So therefore I can say that F2 vector plus minus F1 vector, that should be what? The we need to find out the resultant of them. So clearly both are in 90 degree or else perpendicular to one another. So that's the reason why that resultant should be what? Should be equal to F1 square plus F2 square. So that is what equal to square root of F1 is given as Newton. You have to take 500 square plus 250 square. 250 square. Okay, so try to get the value for F resultant now. So that should be the F, that 250 root 5. We'll get 250 root 5, it seems. Just try to get the right answer. I hope that it should be 250 root 5 Newton. Okay, so that's the force. And the question is to, with respect, you know that you can notice the direction somewhere here like this. Okay, suppose if it's the direction at that time, how will you find out the direction here? As you know that this is some angle theta. This should be the angle theta with the vertical one. So that's the reason why opposite side, we can use tan theta. Opposite side is now F1 vector divided by F2 vector. F2 vector, correct or not? So it should be equal to how much? F1 is given as, right? Should be the 500 divided by 250 will give you what? 2. It implies theta equal to tan inverse of 2 should be the right answer. Theta equal. Okay, so before moving to the next problem, in the previous lectures I have introduced you about An Academy, correct? An Academy, India's largest platform for learning. For computer examinations like Karnataka CET, NEET, JEE, etc., etc., An Academy. Okay, so they are offering the free daily 2020 test for you people. Okay, it's free of cost for you. So there is a free practice test for Karnataka CET 2021 as well as 2022 for you. Okay, it's already started from November 2nd. You can still enroll to the free test for you people. Okay, please kindly make utilize of such opportunities available by An Academy. Okay, coming quizzes for you. Okay, so there is a quizzes as well as test free test for you people. Okay, so upcoming is, it is already missed here, actually test 13, it was on November 18, November 19 will be there, November 20th will be there, so you will definitely get the. So let's do the next problem now. The vector sum of the forces of 10 newton and 6 newton can be. Okay, this is a very good problem. So they have not given the exact answer, right? Because they have not given the angle theta here. Theta is to on the kotela. So that's the reason why. In such cases, what you need to do is, you need to find out the maximum force. Maximum force kandidibeku as well as minimum force kuda kandidibeku. So the resultant force must be lie between maximum as well as minimum. So let's try to find out that. You will get the maximum force when cos theta is equal to how much? Cos theta equal to 1. And you will get the minimum force when cos theta is equal to minus 1. That is the only the difference here. Okay. So for that, what we do is, so therefore we can take the force maximum, that should be equal to square root of, we will take F1 square plus F2 square plus 2 times F1, F2, cos theta is 1 here I have taken, this should be equal to square root of F1 plus F2 the whole square, so that I will get F1 plus F2 here. So that should be equal to 10 plus 6, 10 plus 6 that is what equal to 16 newton here. Okay, similarly, that is the only one possibility is at 8 newton. So that should be the right answer for this question. Okay, can do for minimum. For minimum, F minimum should be equal to square root of F1 square plus F2 square plus 2 times F1, F2, cos theta is, now it is minus 1. Okay, so that says you will get F1 minus F2 the whole square, that equal to F1 minus F2. Okay, so that should be equal to 10 minus 6, that is what equal to 4 here. So the resultant value of F should lie between 4 and 16. Okay, if 4 matte 16 nadune, so this is how you can easily solve the problem. I will upload one more video on the scalars and vectors, and I will in future, I will definitely upload number of videos on scalars and vectors as well as many concepts of physics. Please do watch them as well as share them with your friends and colleagues to help everyone. Okay, so thank you very much. Best of luck.